Hey guys, and welcome back to day 14 of our daily interview coding algorithm. So today we're going to be doing another array-based algorithm. And this one's pretty simple. All you're doing is you're given an array of integers and you're finding the minimum sum, which is obtained from summing every two integers within that array. So here's an example. You're given an array of four integers, so you have to find the minimum possible product that can be made by each of the two integers that can be summed up. So 22, the minimum possible way to get 22 is if you do 2 times 5 and then 4 times 3, and you can see that here. And then you do the same thing here where you've been given 6 integers. So there's a couple of rules to follow. So the array or list, if you want to work with a list, must contain only positive integers, so that makes our life a bit easier. And it's always even in size, so again that makes it easier because you'll see why, but we will need to divide this array up by 2. So the logical way to solve this is you want to first get all of the highest values on one side and then all of the lowest values on the other side. And then you want to kind of work your way inwards. So the highest value on one side multiplied by the lowest value on the other side. And then you want to move inwards again and then inwards again until you're right in the middle. And that's just kind of the general approach you want to take. So a really, really simple step first is you want to sort your array from highest to smallest. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have sample array equals A. So just assign that input. And then I want to do array.sort. And I want to sort that sample array. So now this should be going from biggest to smallest. So that's fine. And if we want to multiply every integer together that's on opposite ends, so right at the start of the array and right at the end of the array, there's a nice simple little algorithm you can use. It just involves a little for loop. So var x equals 0, just set up a standard for loop while x is less than sample array dot length. And what you want to do here is you're going to iterate through that array only up till you're halfway there, because the first half you're going to iterate through, which will be the larger half, and then at the same time you're going to be multiplying it by values from the smaller half. So really you only want to iterate halfway through the array, but you want to constantly be multiplying each value as you iterate through. Because if you iterate through the whole length of the array, what you're going to happen is a crossover like that, and you're just going to carry on summing up products. But you only want to stop once you meet in the middle, and that's going to be halfway through your array length. So I want to do array length divided by 2. And then just increment. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to have a final product. So var final product equals 0. And what I'm going to do is I want to have final product, and I'm going to append to it the value of each product that I'm getting through multiplying the highest and smallest values together. So that highest value is going to be equal to, when it's sorted, I think it's smallest to highest. So the smallest value is going to be equal to sample array and whatever the index of x is. So x starts at 0, it's going to be the first element. And if I want to get the very last element, all I need to do is instead of doing x, which is 0, I want to have the length minus 1 for the very last element. And every time I'm going to subtract whatever x is to start moving inwards. So length minus 1 to get the last element, length minus 2 to get the next element, length minus 3. Whilst at the same time, x is also going to be for getting the smallest element going up in positive increments as opposed to negative. So what that's going to look like is I'm going to have the index of length, and then all we want to do is minus 1 times 1 plus x. And I think that should be okay. And then right at the end, what we want to do is simply return that product. So return final product. Okay, let's give that a test. And we've got an issue. The name length does not exist. So array length. Oh, there we go. It's because what we need to do is sample array dot length minus that. Yeah, okay, that should work. Give that a test. And you can see we've passed all five of our test cases, so that's good. Passed it for empty input and all of the basic tests as well. So there's probably going to be some edge cases when we attempt a full thing, but nope, looks like we passed everything, so that's all good. Can submit that, and there you go. So all you need to do is use a for loop to iterate halfway through the array, and at the same time you want to iterate through the opposite end halfway to the, through the array till you meet in the middle. Then you know you've iterated through every single element and gotten the absolute minimum possible value that you can get. So thanks for watching, guys. That was day 14. Stay tuned for day 15. We'll be halfway through, and I'll see you guys next time. See ya.